Whose side are you on?
And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies.
You know, the people of Nazi Germany couldn't believe what was going on as well, and they said, oh, it couldn't happen here. It's the famous last words, isn't it?
Terry, I sent you a big long message there when you put up something about that, and I said, in Germany, in a town 12 miles away, I don't know from which camp it was, but the German civilians still didn't believe that there had been a genocide.
I've seen something.
And the US Army had to march into the camp to show them the bodies, and they were 12 miles away. That's denial.
My God.
That's
denial. Well, they call it cognitive dissonance.
I can't even pronounce that.
Well, cognitive dissonance, basically, a great example of it is, like, on 9/11, there were stories of people going back as the building, like, the South Tower was falling, and people in the North Tower were kind of there was reports of people running back to their computers to turn them off and all, to turn them off properly and all, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, there was some other crazy suicide banker, as they call him. He was online gambling, you know, on stocks and shares. And then the building went down, and you could hear him screaming and all this. But people just can't believe, you know, how bad things are sometimes. You know, they just refuse to believe in it.
I did. I heard about that, actually. Yeah.
It's like on the Titanic as well. The Titanic was listed over at a 40-degree angle or whatever. Like, there was just mayhem. People just charging down, you know, charging down the corridors of the ship and jumping over the rails of the ship over into the icy cold waters. And, you know, meanwhile, there's other people going back to their cabins for a nap and saying, oh, it's okay, the authorities will fix it and all this, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Well, that's what we're on. We're on a giant Titanic.
Exactly. We're on the Titanic. And that's another great expression about all of this. People obsessing over all these no to taxes and, you know, just little dots in the whole big picture. You know, basically, it doesn't really matter all about, you know, not paying these taxes. Like, it does matter, obviously, but they're focusing on these little issues and basically obsessing on them and giving them, you know,
attention.
It's like rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic, like.
Yeah, it is, Terry. They're giving them attention and they're giving them energy, and it's the IMF.
Exactly.
Simple as.
That's... People can't see that they're conned by the different masks on the same face, you know?
For sure, so simple. I mean, it's the IMF where all these taxes are going.
It blows the mind, doesn't it?
Hmm?
It's so simple, it just blows the mind, like.
It is. I don't understand why people are not getting it.
It's unreal. And it's so simple. Like, you know, our message is simple, you know? The whole thing is rigged by the same guys that have funded Hitler, Stalin. They're back again, you know? They're just masquerading as bankers. They run the whole show. They own everything, the IMF. The European Union, the whole thing was set up to bring us into receivership, you know, so we would default on debt and all the whole thing. I mean, people just don't want to know about it.
And the media got involved by selling the Irish people a dream house, a dream television, a dream car.
Yeah.
You know, at great expense. And they made people feel like they had to buy this stuff to be valid.
Exactly.
You know, they were all in on it.
Yeah.
You know?
They all colluded in it, yes.
Yeah.
Quite deviously, the whole lot of them, all of these industries, yeah.
I am not a number. I am a free man.